Hey YouTube, Chloe here, and welcome back to another hypergamous video. So I wanted to respond to this Tory Lanez pandering publicity stunt for clout that, surprise, surprise, backfired on this clown. But more specifically, I wanted to address the elephant in the YouTube room that 1,200-pound elephant is getting black women to understand that black men as a whole, not individually, are not coming to rescue you. Some of the time, they can throw you a bone, but they're not coming to save the day. They're not coming to sweep you off your feet. They're not riding in on a white horse with wings, and they're not coming to save you. And this is because of the man-first mindset that most black men have and are adamant about. Black men are adamant about being men first. Black men are adamant that their choices are their choices. They're adamant about their preference being their preference, and they are adamant about not owing black women a damn thing. So, for those of you who are living under a rock, R&B singer, rapper, Tory Lanez, Tory Lame, try to hop on the colorism pandering train by trying to position and align himself with the idea of supporting all shades of black women, most notably dark skin representation. So Tory Lanez got busted in a whole manipulative lie about standing up for UK dark skin beauty, I believe her name is Sultry Shen, while filming a music video. But as he tried to paint himself out to be some kind of colorist activist, his claim backfired because Tory the dummy conveniently forgot that the dark skin model without him by sharing the truth of her actual experience. So, as this story continues to collapse like a folding chair, I'm laughing and I'm thinking, how dense can you be? Like, how stupid can you be? Like, you know, now obviously, Tory Lanez isn't the brightest crayon in the box because he didn't do his due diligence in making sure that all were on board to comply with the lie and the pandering, but his fake love does not surprise me in the least. Tory's fraudulent move only tells me one thing, that cancel culture is doing its job, and that black men, particularly celebrity black men, are definitely aware of the fact that dark-skinned black women, brown women, are tired and fed up with the erasure. Black men are aware that black women are tired of being the ignored, denigrated, omitted, and invalidated demographic of women. They are tired of the invisibility and the designation of being the least desired. And black men, black celebrity men, are not only cognizant of this, they're responding by trying to throw black women a bone. Now, Tory Lanez will not be the first celeb to pull this fake love stunt, and he won't be the last, but for real, it's time for black women to put the kibosh on this one-way street of reciprocity when it comes to celebrity men, and black men, especially when it comes to hypergamy. You need to end this kind of relationship, this dysfunctional relationship, with men who are willing to fraudulently lie to black women to con them out of their wallets. It's time for black women to take their time, their attention, their resources, their money, and give it to themselves. It's time for black women to put themselves first. It's time for black women to stop participating in their own erasure. It's time for black women to burn the dust bunny cape and to burn the one-way street. It's time for black women to be hypergamous. It is time for black women to stop waiting for black men to throw them a bone, because I've been watching this type of sinister pandering play itself out for a while, and I am really tired of black men getting clout and brownie points for their fake love and their false appreciation of black women. These celebrity men strategically prey and pander to black women's insecurities by telling black women the script that they want to hear, and they do this while doing the opposite, right? Which is normally, which normally means dating women and giving their resources to women who look nothing like black women. Michael B. Jordan and Donald Glover are the first men that come to mind. Now, from what I understand, Tory Lanez doesn't date black women. He solely dates biracial, mixed, and exotical, and Latina women. So his Instagram hashtag black is beautiful post was suspect from jump. And now we're definitely seeing that his motives weren't genuine. Tory Lanez, like so many other black male public figures, simply do not want to lose the black woman's attention, support, or dollars. So scamming and conning you as black women into believing that he would even give a black woman the time of day is what keeps these singers and actors and entertainers afloat. Now, some thirsty black women are responding to this pandering by saying that black women should be quote unquote happy, that Tory Lanez would bring light to the issue, to his 4.5 million Instagram followers. And to that I say slow clap, because even with the obvious pandering, some black women will continue to ride the magic carpet, the magic ride or die carpet. And some black women are out here doing happy backflips that Tory would even bring attention to this issue, which speaks volumes to how much credit we give to celebrity black men who do the bare minimum. And some black women, in response to this fakery, just come off so dense and desperate for these PR stunt crumbs. And to be honest, it's kind of comes off like secondhand embarrassment. Like, you're so happy and your tail is wagging because Tory Lanez threw you a bone and you get to chew on it. I mean, it's ridiculous. And black women have to do better. Black women individually and collectively have to realize how much power they truly have. Black women are often these R&B artists' bread and butter because, trust and believe, white women, mixed women, and Latina women are not elevating these artists through their pockets, but black women are. And all Tory is going to do, he's going to catch that Jussie Smollett disease and double down on his fraud, make himself out to be a victim, and gaslight black women on his lies to continue to get your support. So, black women, stop supporting these types of men that only like your money and not you. They take your money and then go spend it on these non-black women, then gaslight you when you got something to say about it. You know, rinse, wash, repeat. Heard it all before. So as a solution, and black women have definitely have to get their mindset more into solution mode, which is why you need to subscribe to this channel, because the responding with a solution is the only place where a black woman truly has true power. So that's all I have to say on this for now. Tory Lanez got caught being fraudulent, and he's a sucker and a cornball for that. And as for his damage control response, he can keep it because we don't believe you. And more importantly, black women don't need to believe him. Tory tried to finesse black women with fake positivity and support, and it backfired. But hopefully, black women will continue to wake up and wise up to the pandering, and as a solution, focus on bettering themselves by focusing on improving their hypergamy and their femininity, and focusing on using their buying power to invest in themselves over emotionally investing in someone who just wants access to your wallet. Because too many black women are waiting with bated breath to be validated by celebrities, and too many black women are out here think so little of themselves and their own potential that they're willing to wait for the black men to throw them a bone. So stay tuned for more videos to come, and I will catch up with you in the next one.